So good morning friends, today we will discuss about the lapping process. Okay, now what happened in the IC engine? If the IC engine runs at a very prolonged interval of time, okay, for example if the IC engine runs at 1 lakh to 2 lakh kilometer, then what happened after 1 lakh or 2 lakh kilometer, due to the continuous operation of this valve, that is closing and opening, closing and opening of this valve, what happened, the surface of the walls get deteriorated and there is a leakage of the compression from this valve, that is valve is unable to hold the compression inside the engine cylinder. Okay, this happens due to the wear and tear of the valve seat, that is where the valve is seated on the valve seat. Okay, that is this portion is wear out, and due to which there is a leakage of compression from the engine cylinder. Due to the leakage of compression, the overall pressure built up on the piston cylinder will be less, and there is a loss of efficiency of the engine, that is there is a loss of power and loss of mileage of the engine because of this loss in compression. At the same time, what happened, the lubricant oil which is fitted at this portion to lubricate the valve stem and valve guide, okay, here the lubricant oil passes through this this path, and from this valve seat it will enter into the combustion chamber, especially in intake valve. Okay, so if this valve is intake valve, then what happened, and if this is wear out, then what happened, the oil, lubricant oil from this portion will enter from this valve seat, and finally it enters into the combustion chamber, and in the combustion chamber it will burn in the power stroke. Okay, so whenever there is a power stroke, there is also availability of lubricant oil, due to which there is a blue smoke coming out continuously from the exhaust. Okay, so if there is a blue smoke and loss of power, and at the same time there is a loss of fuel efficiency, then what happened, there is a more possibility or chances that this valve or valve seat will in a worn out condition. Okay, so to rectify this problem, a new valve has to be installed and this valve seat has to be changed. Valve seat and valve has to be changed, and before that the valve and valve seat is lapped. Okay, that is the lapping process should be done before installing this new valve and valve seat. So basically, what is lapping process, that we will see now. Okay, now these are the new sets of valve which has to be installed in the engine. Okay, in this you see, this is the new portion of the valve, and this portion is in contact with the valve seat, and in this figure you see that this portion is little bit rougher side, this is a rough finishing in the on the surface of the valve. Okay, and if this valve are installed directly on the valve seat instead of lapping, then what happened, there are possibility that because of this rough surface there are possibility that the compression may leak out because of this rough surface. Okay, so this is another diagram where I want to explain you why lapping is necessary. So what happened, if the valve is new and valve seat is also new, now this is a valve seat and this is valve, then what happened, the matting surface of this both the part, that is valve seat and valve, is a little bit rough. If you see it under the microscope, you see that there are a lot of irregularities like this. Okay, and when there is a contact of this valve and valve seat, that is when they are in contact, then what happened, there is a possibility that the compression present inside the engine cylinder will escape through these irregularities. Okay, and engine will not hold the compression. Okay, and if the engine will not hold compression, then what happened, there is a loss of power and efficiency, as well as there is a starting problem of the engine. Okay, so for this, the lapping of both the valve seat and valve is necessary. so that this surface will become perfectly smooth like this. Okay, and when there is a contact between this ball seat and wall, there is a no possibility to escape of compression from this wall seat, and all the compression should be maintained inside the engine cylinder so that the engine can run with efficiently. Okay, so for this kind of finishing we have to done the lapping process, and now lapping process is nothing but a micro grinding process, or we call as a super finishing process. Okay, in the lapping process what happened, this is a ball in which this portion has to be lapped circumferentially. Okay, because this portion is in contact with the wall seat, so this portion has to be lapped. So for this lapping process a special wall grinding paste which is having the abrasive particles in it. Now this paste is applied circumferentially around the wall like this. Okay, and when this paste is applied, what happened, this paste has the abrasive particle. Okay, very fine abrasive particles it may be diamond dust, or it may be calcium carbide dust, or any hard material, very hard material. This is the abrasive particle present in this wall grinding tube. Okay, or we can also say that the lapping tube. Okay, now after applying this lapping tube on this wall is inserted on the wall seat. Okay, this is a wall seat, these are the wall seats, and after putting this ball on the wall seat, this has to be lapped like this. This is a power lapping and this is a hand lapping. Okay, now how the lapping is done. Now this is how the lapping is done, in which the this is a lapping tool, and this is the wall, inverted wall inserted in the wall guide. Okay, now these are the wall seats. Okay, circumferentially these are the wall seats. Okay, and on this wall seat the wall has to be inserted like this, and by this tool we can lap it by moving the ball in the clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. So like this, the with the help of hand, this ball has to be lapped like this. Okay, it is rotated in the clockwise and anti-clockwise direction, clockwise and anti-clockwise direction, so that the all the irregular surface present on the wall seat and ball is regularized. So this is another diagram of the lapping. Okay, this is the wall and this is the wall seat, and in between the wall and wall seat there is a abrasive slurry paste. Okay, as I shown earlier, black one, this is the paste, slurry paste. Okay, and what happened when this workpiece that is when the wall and wall seat is rubbed like the rubbed on each other, then what happened, this due to this slurry and due to this abrasive particle, there is a micro grinding takes place between the two work pieces. Okay, and due to this micro grinding, or all the irregularities present on the wall and wall seat is cleared down. Okay, all the irregularities will be cleared, and this surface will become perfectly smooth, and there is a perfect contact between the wall and wall seat. Okay, now whenever there is a perfect contact between the wall and wall seat, there are less possibility of chances that the exhaust gas will escape out from this, and the wall will become perfectly airtight. Okay, so this wall will become perfectly airtight now. This wall will become perfectly airtight after lapping, because all the irregularities between wall seat and wall is now cleared down, and because of this perfectly matting surface, this ball is now able to hold the compression of the engine cylinder on the compression stroke. Okay, and when it holds all the compression, then there is a maximum efficiency of the engine. Okay, now this is a power lapping tool. Okay, now this is basically a drill motor like this, and on this drill motor this is the wall stem is attached, and this is this wall is rotated on the wall seat in the clockwise direction. Okay, so and in between this wall seat and ball there is a abrasive particle slurry. Okay, So when this wall rotate, okay, around this seat, it will perform a micro grinding process, okay, and all the irregular surface of the wall and wall seat will become a regular surface. That is, there is no irregularity present between the wall and wall seat, and this due to this the there is a less possibility of chances that the exhaust gas will be expelled out during the compression stroke. So this is how the lapping process takes place.